7.5 billion people on the planet, all incredibly diverse. Diverse in race, different in culture, varied in tradition and heritage, beautifully colored in all kinds of assorted skin tones. 7.5 billion people, also remarkably unique. Unique in gifts and abilities and talents and skills, unique in passions and preferences and personalities. So my question is this: when a person is transformed by Jesus Christ, and he becomes a new creation like the Bible speaks of, where the old is gone and the new has come, is that diversity and uniqueness erased so we all serve God in the same way? Or is it realigned? Is it re-engineered into a heavenly DNA that inspires us to serve God in our own uniqueness? If God has changed your life and Jesus is Lord of your life, the leader of your life, then I've got great news. He calls you a masterpiece. You are precious because He made you one of a kind. You are priceless because He's the artist, and you are treasured because He alone instilled a godly vision into your heart, an exceptional vision where your greatest joy will meet the world's deepest need. In you, He hasn't just placed strategies so you live a better life on earth. He has sowed something exceptional into your life where your uniqueness will be used to show Christ to the world. He has placed in you a God dream. The challenge is, we take God dreams and we turn them into "it's all about me" dreams. We take God dreams and we turn them into fame and prosperity dreams, where the Savior of the world somehow is downgraded into a supporting role in our life movie. The reality is this: in order for God to become big in our lives, we must become small. And in doing so, God teaches us a powerfully fundamental truth that you and I will never be more alive than when we are doing the meaningful ministry He artistically created us to do. My friend, you are God's masterpiece. And I've got great news for you. You were built for ministry.